guys, and welcome to my YouTube channel. So this is my first video and I hope you'll like it. I decided to go with this desert landscape because it involved a lot of freehand and that's what I like most. I've seen these types of nail art a few times before, such as when Simply Nailogical recreated these nails from one of our followers. There's also designs from nail art by Gracie that I find stunning. I'll insert pictures here. And so yeah, I've always wanted to do one of these, and I stumbled across this thumbnail on YouTube, and I thought it was perfect, so that's why I decided to recreate this image. So the first thing I did was apply a base coat, but I didn't include it because, well, it's boring. Then I applied a coat of white polish. I know it's not fully opaque, but I'm not gonna apply a second coat because I'm gonna do a gradient and then freehand, so the white will be covered anyway. I just needed a base. I applied liquid latex to protect my skin and I let it fully dry. I personally prefer to use acrylic paint for nail art because it's just easier to work with. I also have more bottles of paint than of nail polish. So I took a makeup sponge and applied the pink and the coral paint with a brush. I wasn't happy with how it turned out on the nail. The colors were just too similar and they didn't give me the same gradient as the picture. That's why I added some light yellow to the gradient. When I was happy with the gradient, I removed the liquid latex barrier. Now it's time to use this detail brush with 3 hairs on it and spend 2 hours making tiny lines on my nails. All jokes aside, I started with the sun on my ring finger. I didn't bother making the bottom perfect because it's going to be covered up with dunes anyway. Then I went in and painted all the dunes in order from the top of the nail to the bottom. I did all my nails with one color and then moved on to the next color because I did custom mixes and those are very hard to recreate. Once they dry, maybe they're gone forever, you know? Here is nice footage of me mixing the paint. Okay, now it's time for the cacti. It looks pretty rough right now, but I'm painting it upside down to film this, so that's my excuse. I fixed it and added the grass thingy thing off camera, and I was done with all the painting. The final step is to add a matte top coat. I didn't add the glossy top coat before because this money is all acrylic paint and it just doesn't smear. The only times it smears is when there's only little spots of acrylic paint on top of nail polish, like in this money for example. Anyway, I applied a second matte top coat because the acrylic paint was quite textured and that's not the look I was going for. I hope you liked this video. I'm always open to constructive criticism. If you enjoyed this video, you can leave a like and subscribe to my channel for more videos in the future. You can also follow me on Instagram. My handle is @nailingpainting. Thank you so much for watching and see you next time!